Welcome to one of our virtual sports studios at Viaplay Group, one of the latest fully virtual sets we use.
At Viaplay Sport, our job is to create immersive experiences so that you, the viewer, can sit back and relax while we bring you closer to the action and set the stage for the main sporting event, whatever that may be. We're here to give you some insights of how and why we work in virtual studios and what led us to choosing this path for our productions.
We will guide you through our decision-making process and how this particular set we're standing in came to be.
In 2020, we were given the task of taking the two local design teams we had in Denmark and Sweden and bringing them together to create a centralized look and feel team, which would serve all of our territories across Viaplay Group. Initially, the goal was to ensure that our major markets, Denmark, Sweden, Norway, and Finland, all had access to the same resources with regards to the visual assets that they needed to make their productions. This task later grew to include new markets that were added to our portfolio and which needed to be up and running by 2022, and where the focus needed to be on how we presented our premium rights in the best way possible. This presented an incredible challenge with regards to cost efficiency, as well as how we stayed true to our brand identity throughout our various broadcasts. This brought us to a crossroads. Should we continue down the path of traditional physical studios or venture off into the new frontier of virtual productions? It was not a decision that we took lightly, and clearly there were cons that we knew would challenge us by choosing the virtual path. However, we found that in the end, those were greatly outweighed by the advantages and potential that a virtual setup represented for us. Amongst those, the ability to share efficiently was paramount. We envisioned a future where we could focus all of our energies on single virtual assets, which could then be delivered to all of our territories for use. A studio could be built once, with multiple functionalities, and then be delivered across our territories. We could continuously fine-tune assets, create new ones to our heart's content, and then within days, those elements could be used in different countries by multiple production teams for different rights. The sky truly was the limit. Once the decision was made, the next step was starting. And in order to start, we needed a team.
Our virtual team played a crucial role in the success of this mission. The team consisted of these three talented individuals, each based in a different Nordic country. Jonathan Jurs from Denmark, Robert Anderson, our Swedish connection, and Ulien Atseri, representing Norway. And this exceptional team had a versatile role. They provided critical services, offered support to our local production teams, and demonstrated a strong commitment to learning and mastering the creation of virtual and augmented graphics in Unreal Engine. To ensure the construction of an exceptional and visually stunning set for our broadcasts, we partnered with two key organizations, NEP the Netherlands and Creative Animal. And their role in this project were as follows: constructing the set in Unreal Engine, guaranteeing top-notch quality in all aspects, creating essential functionalities to enhance the viewer experience, optimizing performance. And during the process, our team closely collaborated with them to learn from their expertise. Let's take a look into the process of bringing our football set to life. This set, where I'm standing, was designed to be the central stage for our football shows, including the Premier League, Bundesliga, the UEFA tournaments, and Danish Superliga magazine shows. And we started with defining three guiding principles. We wanted a Nordic influence. We aimed to infuse the set with a distinct Nordic touch and ambience. As a Nordic company, we wanted this set to reflect our Nordic heritage. We wanted to feel physical. We strived for the set to have the appearance of a hard set, something that could have been constructed physically. We wanted to avoid a futuristic or unnatural look. The essence of reality played a crucial role in this aspect. Of course, we also wanted the set to be unique. Unlike typical sports set, we often tend to look uniform. We aim to stand out. Our objective was to create an exclusive and premium atmosphere through careful material selection and unique design choices. In addition to these guiding principles, our brief to Swedish set designer Andreas Bini including the following key elements. We wanted multiple positions for our pundits. We wanted a 360 studio. We wanted to be able to shoot the cameras in all directions. We wanted the feeling to be close to the action. Despite our studio being geographically distanced from the game venues, we sought to establish a strong connection to the actual game locations. The set also needed to be adaptable to different lighting conditions, enabling us to create distinct atmospheres depending on the time of day and where the game was played. And also, to maintain authenticity, we deliberately incorporated imperfections into the design. In a virtual set, we welcome features that would typically be avoided in a physical set, including shadows, material flaws, and possibly even a moiré effect in the LED displays due to pixel pitch. We began with the creation of a physical space blueprint. This blueprint allowed us to assess the available space, the placement of tables and cameras, and making sure we were aware of potential physical limitations. Simultaneously, we were in constant synchronization with our virtual team, addressing practical questions like, can we effectively mask off cameras when they are positioned within the set? Where should we place an over-the-shoulder camera? And this process helped us establish the boundaries we needed to work within. The initial draft from Bini Design offered promising glimpses of what the final set would resemble. It already had striking similarities to our final design, including a connection to the arena, featuring a large screen behind the pundits, and an overall innovative aesthetic. Several iterations and change followed, bringing us progressively closer to our objectives. The concept of having multiple virtual rooms within the set was a revelation. With a mere push of a button, we could alter the set's position, and with that having our pundits in different positions in the set. And this flexibility expanded our storytelling possibilities. Ultimately, the set's design was finalized, and we successfully achieved our goals. NEP, the Netherlands, and Creative Animals delivered an outstanding recreation of the set in Unreal Engine while maintaining performance. The design was done, but we also needed assets to enhance our storytelling capabilities.
The set environment was incredibly important to get right. It is the foundation for the viewing experience. We strived to get it as photorealistic as possible so that when someone was watching a production, they would simply accept what they saw instead of zeroing in on details that might look slightly off. Perfection is difficult, but the true suspension of disbelief was something that we felt was achievable. The next step for us was focusing on the assets within. What were the tools that we would deliver within this space that our production teams could use to tell their stories and entertain their audiences with? While we leaned heavily on NEP to help us bring the studio to life, it was in the creation of these additional functionalities that our team really hit their stride. We had the knowledge and experience of what we wanted to do from a storytelling point of view, and now we had the freedom provided by virtual reality to explore how to do that in new, visually spectacular ways. Logos, stats, profiles, lineups, countdowns, SDI inputs with interviews, EVS packages, or live feeds. All of these and more are the ingredients that we use to spice up a broadcast in order to entertain and bring our viewers along on a ride as we prepare them for the main event. It is here that we truly believe that we differentiate ourselves from the competition and shine when the lights turn on. Using 28 zero-density engines, we are broadcasting in 21 studios across 7 territories in a combination of fully virtual environments, hybrid studios, or AR assets and physical sets. We have gone from leaning heavily on others to producing everything internally. And when compared to where we were when we started, we have easily cut our lead time down by 50%. We can focus on any sport where we are rights holders and create visually stunning set pieces to ensure that our editorial teams can focus on the content and have the confidence that they have the visual tools needed to engage an audience and captivate their attention. Most importantly, whenever we start a new project, we're always looking ahead to how we can get the most out of what we are using our resources on. We can build an environment for one right, yet do it in such a way that we can skin it for the other rights in other territories, which keeps the focus on our initial goal of synergies and cost efficiency and really extend the shelf life of our virtual assets. All of this is made possible by our incredibly talented team of virtual tech developers and the framework and workflow that we have set in place to allow them to do their jobs in the most efficient way possible. It has been an incredible journey. There have been pitfalls and challenges, but it is because of those that today we are light years ahead of where we were when we started. As we look into the future, nothing seems out of reach, and virtually anything is possible.
Thanks for watching, and stream on.